हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल आईटी इंडिया। दिस वीडियो इज रिलेटेड टू टीसीएस एलिवेट विंग 1 डीसीए सितंबर 2021 एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल एबिलिटी सेक्शन एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी पार्ट 5th फॉर न्यूमेरिकल एबिलिटी सेक्शन। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इफ के इंटू 3 मेडियन माइनस मोड इज इक्वल टू मीन, देन द वैल्यू ऑफ के इज। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू मस्ट नो द रिलेशन बिटवीन मीन, मोड एंड मेडियन। सो द रिलेशन इज mod is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean, and we are given this equation. First of all, we should have it in the similar pattern. So 2 mean is equal to 3 median minus mod, and here we are given k 3 median minus mod is equal to mean. And if we compare with this equation, this portion here is same, and but here should be 2. Here should be 2. How we can get 2 here? If value of k is equal to 1 by 2, then this 2 will go in cross multiply with this mean. So we will get 2 mean equal to 3 median minus mod, and which is our standard relation, and this is our standard relation. So the value of k here is 1 by 2. Now if x is the mean of the data 6, x, 2 and 4, then the mod is. So first of all, mean of the data is sum of observation divided by number of observation is equal to mean, and we will use the same formula in this question also. So 6 plus x plus 2 plus 4, and what is the number of observation here? 1 2 3 4, so it will be equal to 4, and mean is given to us is equal to x. So, and this will be in cross multiply, so 6 plus 2 plus 4, it will be equal to 12, x plus 12, and it will be equal to 4x. Now it will be equal to 3x, 12 is equal to 3x, and the value of x will be 4. Now data will be equal to 6, 4, 2, 4, and the most frequent observation now is 4, because it is repeated 2 times. So mode of the data will be 4. Now next one, refer the below data table and answer the following question. So in this table, we are given with items, raw materials, labor, rent, interest, taxes, and yearly expenses in rupees and lakhs. And the question here is, raw material and interest are what percent of the total expenses? So raw material here is 4 and interest is 6. So sum of these two will be equal to 4 plus 6 is equal to 10. And now sum of all the expenses will be equal to 4 plus 3, 7. Plus 4, 11, plus 6, 17, plus 1, 18. So 10 by 18 into 100 will be the required percentage. It will be the percentage of raw material and interest to the total expenses. So it will be equal to 5 divided by 9 into 100. It will be equal to 500 divided by 9. It will go 5 times, 45, 5, and it will again go 5 times, 45, 5 will be there again, and it will again go 5 times. So 55.5, this will be your correct answer. Now the mean of the observation is 5. If 2 is added to each observation and then multiplied by 3, then what will be the new mean? First of all, number of observation given to us is 10 and mean is 5. And we know that mean is equal to sum of observation divided by number of observation. And here we have number of observation 10 and mean is equal to 5, and sum will be equal to 5 into 10 is equal to 50. So sum of observation as of now is 50. But if 2 is added to each observation, then sum will be equal to 10 इंटू टू इज इक्वल टू 70 बिकॉज वी आर एडिंग टू इन ईच ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड देयर आर 10 ऑब्जर्वेशन सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू 10 इंटू टू इज इक्वल टू 70 बट नाउ इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 3 ईच ऑब्जर्वेशन इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 3 लेट इट बी एक्स इंटू 3 प्लस एक्स इंटू 3 प्लस एक्स इंटू 3 इट मे बी टिल द नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन सो हियर वी कैन टेक 3 कॉमन इफ वी टेक 3 कॉमन what will be remain inside it will be the sum of observation similar thing we will do here sum of observation as of now is 70 and we have taken you can assume 3 common so we are multiplying here by 3 so sum of observation will become 210 then what will be the new mean it is asked in the question and observation r is still 10 so new mean will be 21 it will be divided by 10 0 will be cancelled and 21 will be left so 21 is your correct answer The distribution of weight in kg of 44 student in a class is as follows. Weight 35 to 38. Number of student 3. 38 to 41. It will be of 13 student. 41 to 44. 13 student. 44 to 47. 10 student. 47 to 50. 5 student. Then what is the average weight of the class? So first of all, we have to calculate the mean weight of each class. Mean weight. So 35 plus 38 divided by 2, it will be equal to 36.5. And now 38 plus 41 is equal to 79 divided by 2 will be equal to 39.5. And now 41 plus 44 divided by 2 will be equal to 42.5. Now 44 plus 47 is equal to 91. Divided by 2 equal to 45.5 and here pattern is followed plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 it will be equal to 48 and you can simply calculate basically there is difference of 3 and the mean will be in between them so it will be either plus 1.5 in 35 or minus 1.5 in 38 so 35 plus 1.5 will be 36.5 and 38 plus 1.5 will be equal to 39.5 So it will be easier. Now, weight of each class 3 into 36.5, 13 into 39.5, and similarly, we have to calculate for each class. And it will be equal to 36.5 into 3, it will be equal to 109.5. Now, 13 into 39.5, it will be equal to 513.5. 42.5 into 13, 552.5 and it will be simply 455 and 448.5 into 5 will be equal to 248.5 and now we have to add all these 242.5 plus 455 plus 552.5 plus 513.5 plus 109.5 it will be equal to 1873 I have used calculator in this question but you have to solve yourself and now there are 44 students so you have to divide 1873 by 44 divided by 44 it will be equal to 42.56 so option C will be correct now cumulative frequency of a distribution is given below Which of the following class has maximum frequency? So how we can calculate frequency of each class? So this will be frequency and frequency of this class is 3. And frequency of second class will be 20 minus 3 means 17. Because cumulative frequency is frequency of present class plus frequency of all previous classes. Like in this case, this frequency is frequency of this class plus this class. And in this case, frequency of all these three is 36 so this is the method so we are just simply doing the reverse of finding the cumulative frequency here cumulative frequency is 20 so 20 minus 3 is equal to 17 now and here 36 minus 20 it will be equal to 16 and here 48 minus 36 it will be equal to 12 and here 50 minus 48 it will be equal to 12 so the class which has maximum frequency will be this 63 to 65 means option A is correct. Now, if the mean of a set of observation x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus till x10 is 50, then the mean of x1 plus 5, x2 plus 5 till x10 plus 50 is. So, first of all, here we are given with this, and here this is also same. But what is happening here? We are just adding this series 5 plus 10 plus 15 plus plus till 50. So simply we have to calculate the sum of this series, and after that we have just to divide that sum by 10, and that will be mean of this particular series, and we have to add that mean in this 50, and that will be our final answer. So first of all, sum will be equal to n by 2 into a plus l. And what is a? A is the first term of any series. And what is l? L is the last term of that series. And what is n? N is the number of terms. And here it is already given to us that number of terms are 10. So simply put 10. And here it is 2, not 10. And number of terms are 10 divided by 2 into a. What is first term? 5. What is last term? 50. So sum will be, it will be cancelled, 5 into 55. So it will be equal to 5 into 5 is equal to 25, and 5 into 5 is equal to 25 plus 2, 275. And we have to divide it by 10 because we have 10 terms. Average of this series will be 27.5. And already we had mean 50. So 50 plus 27.5. This will be our new mean. So it will be equal to 0.577. So 77.5. Option A is correct. Now, let X be the median of the data. 13, 8, 15, 14. This is the data. If 8 is replaced by 18, then the median of the data is Y. What is the sum of the values of X and Y? First of all, to find the median, we have to arrange any series either in ascending order or in descending order. So here we are arranging them in ascending order. So first of all, 8 will be here, then 9, then 13, and 13 is repeated 2 times. It will be 13, then 14, 14, 14, 14. It will be 4 times. 14, 14, 14, and 14. And now 15. After that 16 and 16. It is 2 times. 16 and 16. 9 is already taken. And what is left? 17 and 17. And what is left now? 15 is also 1 more, 2 more times. So here we are putting 15, 15. So number of terms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So all terms are represented here. Now what will be median? Median here is X, and it should be n plus 1 by 2 term. So here n is 15. So 15 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 8th term will be our median. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 14 is our median. But now 8 is replaced by 18. So there will not be any 8, but here will be 18. So now still median will be 8th term, but we have to find which is 8th term now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now 15 is our 8th term. So Y is 15. So we have to find the value of X plus Y, that is sum of X and Y. So it will be equal to 29. So option B, 29 is correct. So guys, this was all in this video. Thanks for watching this video, and please do subscribe this channel.